Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. The U.S. Supreme Court ruling on the health care law, its impacts in New Hampshire. Let's first look at small business. And here are the provisions that were upheld. You can keep your current insurance plan if it was in place before March 2010. By 2014, all plans must guarantee coverage. And by 2014, new plans, there's no premium rating that can be based on health status as a criteria and no pre-existing conditions. Now, 2014, each state determines the minimum benefit package, and by 2014, you can purchase insurance from an exchange in each state. More on that in a minute. And 2014, again, businesses more than 50 employees are taxed if they're not providing health insurance. And by 2014, businesses less than 50 employees are exempt from that kind of a penalty. And finally, 2010 to 2013, employers' tax credit is available up to 35% of the premium costs. And by 2014, employers' tax credit is up to 50% of the premium costs, at least for 2 years, and there are grants for wellness programs. Now, with me to talk about the other impacts on New Hampshire is Steve Norton, director of the Center for Public Policy here in New Hampshire. Welcome, Steve.
Thank you, Fred.
Nice to have you. There are other impacts, in particular on Medicaid and on these exchanges that we talked about. How about Medicaid?
So first, the court ruled that the federal government cannot require states to expand the Medicaid program as the bill indicated. And I think that what that means for the state is we're going to be having a conversation probably in 2014, as we did in the 90s, about children, whether we're going to expand to very poor individuals making less than 100% of the federal poverty level.
Right. And the Medicaid program, of course, just was changed in New Hampshire.
That's correct.
And to a managed care plan.
That's correct. Part of the last legislative budgetary conversation, the legislature mandated the department to move forward with the three-phased implementation of managed care. Part one was acute care, hospitals, and the like, and behavioral health, and the other parts will be the more long-term care services.
And it's a cutback in available money in that plan.
That's correct. That's right.
Okay. And New Hampshire has resisted the health care plan put forth by the Congress that was just upheld by the court.
That's correct.
In general.
That's right. In general, the state has been hostile to the concept of the Affordable Care Act, and in particular, the health insurance exchanges, which are the set of shopping areas, if you will, where people could go and buy health insurance coverage. As it stands right now, the state will have the federal government impose a federal health insurance exchange on the state in New Hampshire. There are a handful of other states that decided not to move forward with their own exchange. New Hampshire is one.
We actually sent the money, the planning money for that exchange, back to the federal government.
We did. That's correct.
So the feds will now come in and do it for us.
That's right. Yep.
What's your general reaction to the Supreme Court ruling? I mean, you deal with the public policy all the time. You used to work in Washington at an institute in Washington. You know Washington. Mm-hmm. You know the culture down there. Mm-hmm. Now you know the culture of New Hampshire, and you and your colleagues do a lot of research into issues around New Hampshire, including health care. What's your reaction to the ruling?
I think it puts the conversation firmly back in the political environment. In other words, provide some clarity in the short term, but says to the political world, it's time for us again to have another conversation about what is the right path, what's the right relationship between the state, the federal government, and private enterprise in the healthcare arena. Regardless of who's in power, whether it's the Republicans or the Democrats, that conversation is going to be had and is going to be played out in the next congressional cycle as well.
Right. What's the biggest challenge facing New Hampshire with this upholding the law by the Supreme Court? What's our biggest challenge going forward?
I think small businesses and large businesses, to some extent, have a little bit more clarity in what might happen, and I think that they need to start investing in educating themselves about the opportunities and challenges associated with it.
Steve Norton, director of the Center for Public Policy here in New Hampshire, all too short on a very complex subject. Thank you. We'll get back to this again. If you want to see this interview again, you can go to WMUR.com. Just click on Project Economy, click on News, and then go to Project Economy.